sessions, and that the main sessions are interpreted and in a large room. There was a proposal to see if we could get the BPFs and the dynamic coalitions to share a slot. Very quickly, that was ruled as not workable for either one of them. Basically, it didn't give either one of those communities enough time to accomplish their work. And I think there's been a strong request from the BPFs for a three-hour slot. So they were agreed at the last MAG meeting for a main session slot, large room interpretation. We're trying to find a way to give them 2 hours. I think they've come in with a strong request for three. So I guess against that criteria, I guess we're sort of two-thirds committed or something. Let me, DCs. So let me ask Marcus to come in and explain the current state of that. And then, Vera, we will go to you in just a moment as well. Marcus, you have the floor.
Yes, thank you, Lynn. Yes, you're correct. We had a decision in principle to give a slot, a main session slot, with all interpretation to BPFs and to dynamic coalitions, but it was open whether it be a full session or a half session, so to speak. And now we seem to be moving towards merging the best practice forums with connecting the next billion as one intersessional activity. And the question is now whether or not to give the dynamic coalitions a half slot of 90 minutes or a full slot. And I saw Virat's proposal, and speaking on behalf of the dynamic coalitions, I would like to reiterate their request for having a full slot. They had done a lot of work, and we had started immediately after João Pessoa having calls of taking stock and how to move forward. We had presented at the MAG meeting in April in Geneva that we had moved towards a common shared principles. There were some comments made by people present, and we had taken that into account. One comment was that dynamic coalitions should commit themselves to take on board dissenting opinions. They agreed to that in principle. And now we have started on preparing a main session, and the paper is included in the annex Cheng Dai had sent out. Avri had given a first presentation 2 days ago, and the dynamic coalitions really have come a long way towards moving. If you recall, the starting point was how can we integrate them into the main work of the IGF, and they have come a long way. We are not there yet, and their proposal is to have a hybrid session. Half of it would be devoted to horizontal issues common to all dynamic coalitions, such as processes and procedures. And one issue that was of concern to many MAG members, and it was also mentioned 2 days ago, was will there be outcomes, will there be seeking endorsement by the MAG, and this is for the time being off the table, but the dynamic coalitions are working towards finding procedures that would allow that, but we are not there yet. Having said that, having one half of the session devoted to horizontal issues such as common procedures, and the other half would be devoted to individual dynamic coalitions. We have 14 of them who would like to be present. You can do the maths. That doesn't give much time, even 90 minutes divided by 14. And they agreed to keep it very short. They will provide a background paper, and the sessions will be more tweet-like. And we agreed on what some people, the term we used as a working term was an agent provocateur, who would actually challenge the dynamic coalitions and ask questions that would provoke them into an answer, but all very short, tweet-like. And I think an important part of it was also the request by the dynamic coalition to have a tweet wall. But I'm turning to Avri, the co-facilitator. Maybe she has something to fill in which I may not have mentioned. But again, to repeat the plea for a full session for the dynamic coalitions, it is an important part of intersessional work we have had right from the beginning, and integrating them in the mainstream, I think, goes a long way towards strengthening the outputs of the IGF. Thank you.
Thank you, Marcus. Avery, you have the floor.
Avery speaking. Marcus basically said most of it, but what I really wanted to emphasize was two points. One is the continuity of work that goes on in the dynamic coalitions. They're, at the moment, still the only part of what we do in the IGF that is on a full year's work cycle and isn't something that starts and stops with every, you know, after a meeting, go into hiatus, and then once there's a new mag, start again. These are groups that are working, you know, 12 months a year, you know, in terms of getting their stuff done. So I think that's a very important part of supporting it. I think the other important element is we're still in the process of building the faith between the dynamic coalitions and the work they're doing and the comfort of the other IGF participants who worry about their outputs, who worry about what it means to have a dynamic coalition working in a bottom-up manner and integrating their work with the rest of the IGF community. So I think that that is one of the parts that makes it very critical that they do have the main session and they have it in a way that everybody can understand what's going on so that we can continue to build a sort of faith and trust between the work that's being done there and the rest of the IGF. So thank you.
No, thank you, Avery. I'm going to go to Virat, who kindly ceded his time a moment ago to set this stage here. I'll let the conversation on main sessions move, hopefully until we've got some high-level direction for how we're going to move forward, but then quite quickly move back to the workshop selection so we can complete that process. I know there was a lot of good work done over lunchtime. So, Virat, you have the floor.
Thank you. Can you hear me now?
Very well.
Can I be heard?
We can hear you very well, Virat.
Okay. Thank you. So I just wanted to come in earlier, but you know I want to thank the team that is helping us with this remote participation, especially Anna. She's worked through the lunch to get this thing working while all of us were away at lunch or dinner. But I'm really thankful to her for all the work she's done. It's been difficult and an outstanding effort by the team. On the main session, as the co-lead of the working group along with Liesl, I wanted to just make a couple of recommendations that will help us make a final decision on both the numbers of main session and the durations. After every IGF, we talk about too many main sessions and we want to cut them short, etc. And then we come back and we have more proposals than we have slots. In principle, we have a basic structure which has a grid, 3 hours before lunch, 3 hours after lunch. So essentially, we have two main taken. If you could see my email, it states one on day one after lunch and one post lunch on day four, essentially leaving us with six slots. So I might stand corrected, but I think Chengat, I said seven. I think we have six slots.
We have six slots, Virat. That's right.
To accommodate proposals that we have. If we go with six straight, we can just go with. So actually, I heard him say seven, so that's why I wasn't sure what that was. So if it is six slots, if you look at the options that are there in the email. If you pick all six slots, six out of the nine proposals, we can just easily fit them at 3 hours each. If we pick seven sessions out of the nine proposals, we can do five main sessions of 3 hours each. And we can do either two main sessions of 90 minutes each or one main session of 2 hours and one of 90 minutes each. So on and so forth. If you do eight main sessions out of the nine, we'll be able to do four 3 hours each, and the remaining will have to be of shorter duration. They can be of 90 minutes each, or a few can be 2 hours and 90 minutes. And if you pick all nine, even then we can. I recommend not picking all nine because that will really squeeze sessions. There are also graphic details available. If you look at the attachments, you will see how the panel comes. As we start every day, which is at 10, it must break for lunch at the same time, which is 1. It must again start at 3 o'clock post-lunch. So if we have to make any changes or extra time, it would have to be on day 2 and 3 post-lunch in the second session. Usually we end at 6 if we pick up more than 6 or 7 sessions, then we'll probably end up at 6:30 some days. The short point is that we can accommodate 7 or even 8 main sessions. Ideal is 6, and we shouldn't go beyond that, but there is a possibility to do that. So I wanted to leave that with you because, you know, I wouldn't be able to contribute in the ongoing discussion. The audio sometimes is not there at all. But this might help you make the decision. And then there are those, if you can click on the graphics, you will see below, that it can help you get an idea physically of how those sessions will run. And how they will sort of go off. If we go with 90 minutes, then there is no issue. But if you go with a combination of 2 hours and 90 minutes, then we will have to go 30 minutes off. Just one last point. Any variable sessions which are of 2 hours and 90 minutes must be scheduled in the second half if they're back-to-back. You can do 2 90-minute sessions at any time you want. But if we choose the duration of 2 hours and 90 minutes, then we should pick it in the second half so that the grid by and large and the delegates know what time the conference begins, what time the lunch starts. It is also important because these are the slots that we use for workshops and open forums, which are also divided in 90, 60, and 30-minute slots. So they all fit into the three-hour slots everywhere. So that's it. I just wanted to leave that with you. This is helpful during the discussions in the next day or so. Next 2 hours or so. Hopefully we can...
Thank you, Virat. Thank you for all the work and for the very detailed memo as well. I did just check with Yolanda here, and in fact, their intent is to use non-UN interpreters, which gives a little bit more flexibility and potentially a longer working day, an earlier start, perhaps. I would hope most of you would think that that was good news. So I think there's a number of things we could do with respect to perhaps some of the flexibility around the main sessions and things. I think Virat laid out a number of proposals. I think I would just like to underline that at the last MAG meeting, I think we clearly agreed that the NRIs got a main session slot, and we clearly agreed that Best Practice Forum had a slot as well, and that's now, it seems, going to be merged with or shared with the Connecting and Enabling the Next Billions. There is a question in front of us on the dynamic coalitions. As I said a moment ago, I think we sort of two-thirds agreed. We did agree at the last MAG meeting that they would be given a main session slot for the larger room and the interpretation. It was pretty clear then that they were looking for a minimum of 2 hours, and I think have come back now with a fairly complete proposal on the 3 hours. I'd like to just clear that up and underline that once and for all so we can move forward with the rest of the planning. So I'd like to open, there are a number of people in the queue, but what I'd like to hear on specifically is whether there is support for the dynamic coalitions having a three-hour main session, which again means larger room and interpretation. So if people can, I don't know how to manage it when you've got this kind of queue. It's not so easy as putting your flag down and your flag back up. But is there anybody who would like to speak against the dynamic coalitions having a three-hour main slot? Sure. Elizabeth has a clarifying question. You have the floor.
Sorry. I don't want to speak against them having a large slot, but I do want to share some feedback, I think, and something for consideration in our discussion. My sense was that we tried this last year as an experiment, and I was in the main session room, and it wasn't a very full session, and it wasn't something where people were very interactive outside of the dynamic coalition presentations. So I think, like everything, once you try an experiment, you learn from your experiences and all of those things. Thoughts around how maybe to change that would be that if I were to look on a program and I saw dynamic coalitions, it doesn't resonate with me. It makes me feel like I'm outside that group and I don't know where my link is. And so there are a lot of really interesting topics within the dynamic coalitions. And so I would discourage the organizers and the groups from getting into many process internal discussions that for a huge number of people at that event will not be relevant and will make them feel like it wasn't, not understand why it has a main stage. I would really encourage them to take some of their substance and make it seen in the explanation of what they're doing, that these are the kind of topics that they do. I would encourage them to frame and make it clear, you know, that in many cases they're kind of, you know, they're how they come to do this and what's sort of unique and original about the way that they do it, so it isn't mistaken for other activities that are done. And so if perhaps some of the internal about us and how we work discussion was taken off the agenda, there would be more space it would be flexible to cut it down to a 2-hour session. And I don't think using a main stage for an internal type business, how we're governed discussion is a good use of IGF time.
No, and I think those are very good comments. I, too, was in the Dynamic Coalition session last year. I wonder if there's an opportunity, given there's a extra room, so to speak, and there will be interpretation in 3 languages in that room, if it would be possible to move the organizational or management session of the DCs to one of those rooms and maybe still save the other 90-minute session for a main session in one of the full rooms, which would be the one that might address more of the content. So I just put that out there for the moment. I think we have a lot of other decisions in front of us with respect to the other main sessions as well, and we'll probably have to swirl through these a few more times. I have quite a queue, so let me go through the queue. And again, this is trying to identify for the 10 main sessions that are proposed. Are they all relevant? Are they all appropriate for a main session slot? And I think we should have the discussion on that merit. And then depending on that particular answer, we can go away and work out some of the scheduling problems. So I have Peter next in the chair. Peter, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I defer to the much greater experience and brain power of Virat and others on actually organising the logistics, so I don't think I can help much there. In relation to the dynamic coalitions, I was of the impression as a MAG member that we had agreed to a session. I don't particularly have a view as to whether it should be a 2.5 or a 3-hour session, but it seemed that we had already agreed, as far as I can recall, to that, and I think, you know, that we should go ahead with that. My concern, though, really why I put my hand up was to comment on another proposal, and so if I can do that. I've had only had a quick read through the proposals, and I think there are some problems that we should address with proposal number one. This is a proposal that talks about the devolution of the internet and the post-IANA world, which are very interesting topics, but I'm not quite sure that this is ready for prime time. The technical approach that's taken is that there will be a series of national intranets set up, presumably under governmental control, and that the current internet is going to act as the linking gatekeeper between these intranets, which is completely different from current technology. So there would have to be quite a lot of technological improvement and innovation done before that would become a realistic technical proposal. So I'm not sure how helpful it is at this stage to talk about it when there isn't a technical underpinning for it. And the second part, in terms of the post-IANA discussion that it wants to have, again, I think that's a very interesting topic. I don't think it takes quite into account all the recent developments that have gone on at ICANN in terms of creating a post-IANA transition structure. And in any event, that's covered by a number of workshops. So it seems to me that, interesting stuff, but not quite ready for a couple of reasons yet to have a whole main session. Perhaps we can take some of those bits feed them back into some of the workshops and see how it goes. Thanks.
Thank you, Peter. European Commission.
Thank you, Chair. I also wanted to share some general remarks on the main sessions. So looking at the topics that we have here, I think that at least it strikes me that we don't have anything about cybersecurity and cybercrime, which is an area that presents still significant challenges and is an area of continuous global concern. And it would be nice to be able to bring forward in a main session also the discussions that have taken place already in the past on this issue. I know that this is not very helpful because we need to eliminate some of the topics, but I think that cybersecurity is an important topic that should be in a main session. Also, that maybe this another topic that is missing is maybe the emerging issues. And here, a possibility could be maybe to enlarge a little bit the topic shaping the future of internet governance, which was proposed by Liesl and Flavio. Maybe this is just a suggestion. You could consider something a bit broader, like shaping the future of the internet and its governance. In this way, you would have a forward-looking exercise where you think about how will be the internet in the future and which governance it will require. It's just a suggestion. And finally, I would like to say that the main session on trade agreements and the internet looks very topical. In particular, if it could be enlarged to cover also digital economy aspects, which is a broader topic that has been at the center of some high-level discussions this year, including the OECD meeting in Cancun, it's also discussed at G7, G20 sessions, and in a way, it is related to the fourth industrial revolution that we are entering. So, yes, these are my remarks. Thank you.
Thank you, Christina. Very helpful. Izumi, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. So my understanding of the main session is the theme should be like relevant to the wide audience. So first comment on the dynamic coalition. I think your suggestion, Chair, makes sense that perhaps to pick the topics that's relevant to the wider audience from the dynamic coalition, allocate that for 90 minutes. And then for the administrative matters on how to like exchange information about organization of dynamic coalition, I think it's more relevant to the organizers of the dynamic coalition. So that's like splitting approach seems to make sense for me. And that's, I understand that's what the NIRs are doing. So they have a main session that's relevant for everyone and then have a separate smaller session for like NIR organizers. I'd also like to comment on main session number one, which will cover the that mentions the topic of internet and the IANA stewardship transition. Again, going back to my point that it should be like of a wider interest. And I think this topic of internet is, I think, very specific. And I would actually rather suggest that since it mentions the word cybersecurity, there was a suggestion from the European Commission to have a main session on cybersecurity. So rather focus on that theme and expand on that rather than just pick a very specific topic about the internet. That's my thoughts. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. I've got, roughly probably 15 people in the queue. So if people could keep their comments quite to the point, we can hopefully make a lot of progress here in the main sessions before reverting back to the workshop selection. Marilyn, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. Marilyn Cade speaking. I also have some concerns about workshop one. I agree largely, Peter, with what you said. I think sometimes there's a topic of particular interest, but in my view, to be a main session, we really have to have gone through some workshop kicking and screaming level work in many cases, and also to try to find whether or not there's enough commonality and understanding to move it to a main session. So I actually cannot fully support one as rising to the level of main session. I also note that one of the proposals is referred to as a follow-on to a sustainable development workshop last year proposed by two business representatives, Hussan, who is a part of the business community, and Elizabeth. I think I don't really think that that can be, to me, it really, perhaps it could be a 90-minute session since it's referred to as a follow-on. And then on the trade one, I have a couple of concerns about, right now we are proposed to be thinking about merging some of the trade workshops, and I'd like us to get through whether or not we're really going to make those mergers happen, and then possibly look at if this is about the digital economy and trade, then perhaps it would could be collapsed as well. And then finally, on the future of the internet, I do think that a youth session, a youth-directed session, I hope I'm being clear, that a youth-directed session would be organized by youth with much more of a focus on the full range of youth between the age of 18 and the age of 28, roughly the UN definition. So it would be three categories of ages, and that it would be much more organized about how youth are being affected by the internet, being affected by the online world, the future of work in an online world, the future of living in an online world. And I think that would be very, very different from the proposal we have right now. So I sent Lisa a note, but I think it's the right concept, but could be completely reformatted and be much more engaging of bringing youth into a main session. Maybe it needs to just be a 90-minute session, but I think the idea of taking such a session and giving it some main visibility and engaging youth in putting forward such a session could be very exciting.
Thank you, Marilyn. The queue is closed now on this particular topic. There's, 17 or so more people. By that time, I will have heard from virtually all the MAG members here in the room, I would suspect, and I think we'll have enough of an indication as to what the next steps are, and that should allow us to go back to the workshop proposals. So, Ephraim, you needn't have left the queue. You were the last one in. Michael, you have the floor.
Just very, very quickly, one question we should ask ourselves is, how do these decisions we make this year look when we compare to what happened last year and the year before? And how will it affect what we do in the future? It may be because I've been on the MAG for 3 years, but I tend to think in the three-year cycle, what I'm hearing some people say is, well, we need to have this kind of session because we had it last year. And the assumption is we'll have it next year. That doesn't leave a lot of room if we lock in several topics and give 3 hours to these topics each year. So we should be ready to say, no, we did that last year. We'll wait 2 years before we come back to that topic. Related to that, last year we did have a main session on cybersecurity and trust, and it was very broad and it was little unsatisfying for those of us in cybersecurity. I think this year we have some more specific topics, and I think that's good because it leads to more debate and you get a tighter panel of people talking about the topic. But I do hope that as we think about which ones we don't need to do this year, we will think how maybe it's okay to wait 2 years or even 3 years before we revisit a particular topic. And just on one specific one, I do have some concerns about number one as well, as others have expressed. And I do think dynamic coalition could be handled in 2 hours because, again, we did it last year. We'll probably do something next year.
Thank you, Michael. I think it was a good point that we should be looking forward and using these main sessions in particular to drive some of our interest going forward. Flavio, you have the floor.
Thank you, Lynn. Two comments. The first one, I would like to second positions already expressed by Elizabeth and by Izumi regarding a concern on the sessions on the dynamic coalitions and NRIs, that they should really make the effort not to deal with administrative matters during the time of the main session and leave this for separate sessions. I remember that last year we already had this discussion about this difference between thematic main sessions and organizational ones, that we should have room really for main sessions discussing very substantive issues on subjects that are of wide interest to the communities and not for particular IGF matters, organizational matters, I would say. So this is one question. So the other one is a response to Marilyn, an information that is given to me from the organizers of workshop 179, which is the origin of this proposal by Liesl and supported by me regarding this main session involving the youth. So the youth, they are involved, the young people, involved not only as proposed speakers, but also as organizers in the workshop. So there is, we can see the list of youth representatives that are confirmed. We have Adela Goberna, 23 years old, from Argentina, president of the Youth Observatory, which is a special interest group from ISOC. Angelica Contreras, 25, important Mexican internet activist, deeply engaged in women's rights on the internet environment. Kimberly Anastasio, 21, Brazilian prominent young researchers on IT governance. Florian Daniel, British entrepreneur, very engaged youth at InSafe Network in Europe. Bianca Ho, from Hong Kong, youth representative appointed by the UN to the MAG, also Net Mission Ambassador. And Efraim Kenyanito, 22, from South Africa, member of the Steering Committee for the Youth Coalition on Internet Governance and youth representative at the MAG. So we have really youth representatives from all continents, not only as speakers, as confirmed speakers, but also involved in the organization of the event. So I think the concerns from Marilyn are adequately covered already. Thank you.
Thank you. Juan, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. Main sessions are the main event on the IGF and are the events that are organized by us. So I think we have to be, those are the events that we have to be without any doubt that are really relevant and that really keeps on interesting. So having said that, I want to comment on the particular of this year. I always defended the best practice forum and dynamic coalitions because are part of what I call the permanent things of the IGF. That it's not 1 year to 1 year, but it's going on all year. So I defend that strongly. But I agree with Elizabeth that maybe the main session is not the, and also let me say, and I think that we have to strengthen both best practice forums and dynamic coalitions. And last year we had a very important conversation regarding dynamic coalition and trying to institutionalize those. But having said that, I agree with Elizabeth that maybe we have to think if the format of a main session is the better way to really strengthen a dynamic coalition and best practice forum as a permanent movement within IGF. We have to think that. I'm not saying now if it's for or not, but we have to think about that, stressing that those are the permanent things. And now going back to the main sessions proposed, first, before giving my endorsement to anyone, I feel that whatever six we select, we will have to rework them and to increase and to perfect them, no matter how good we think they are now, because I repeat, these are the main events. Having said that, I don't want to disqualify any. I just want to say the ones that by reading only the topic, it really strikes me as relevant. For instance, going from down to up, economic, social, and cultural right, what are the implications for the internet and sustainable development? That's really innovative in this. That really gets my attention. The other one that is there, assessing the role of internet governance in sustainable development goals, I think that's also something that needs to be addressed, because we want to align ourselves with the sustainable development goals, but we don't know how. You know, ITU has done this matrix and all that somebody defends, somebody not. So to have a conversation with everybody there around this, I think it's very important in this year. And let me move that up. And shaping the future of internet governance. I like the title. I don't like so much the way that it's done inside, because it's more like a conversation of opinion. But going back to the title, internet governance is in a flux. Many things are going on. You know, initiatives grow, get born and die, the IANA transition. There's a lot of things going on in internet governance. And I like the idea to put young people to talk about that with old people, but I think we need to put in, if this is selected, to put a little more structure in that discussion in order to have it more steered towards some sort of useful conclusions. Those are the ones that really strikes me as relevant for this year. The other are interesting, but as has been said before, some are continuation from last year, and maybe it is not. I'm also not sure that national and regional initiatives, also the format of a main session, is the way for doing this, because main sessions are the main event where the people that go for an IGF for the first time, where the political or the important people go there and see. So that's my idea.
Thank you. I think there were very good comments, although I might suggest that instead of old people, we say longtime practitioners or something. No, but Giacomo, you have the floor.
Yes, thank you. I want to say that first, about the idea to modify the dynamic coalition slot or even the regional and national IGF initiative slot, seems to me, first, something that is wrong in principle, because as has been correctly said, these are the permanent tools that make the life of the IGF all along the year. So it will be really the wrong move to do. The second is that I don't understand why we come back on already taken decision, because people has not eventually proposed workshops, because they were sure that they will have a slot in the plenary. So now we will say to them that they cannot anymore propose a workshop, but they will not have any more the slot, or they will have a reduced slot. Seems to me unfair. And in general, I don't like that we change minds so often. On the other point, I think that the proposal of the European Commission to merge the trade and the digital economy seems very good, because the one is a little bit unbalanced towards civil society, and the second is a little bit unbalanced toward the private sector. So merging together the two would be beneficiary for both, because I think the digital economy, sustainable economy, and trade are absolutely interlinked. So my suggestion would go for a merge of these two plenary sessions. And then if there is a problem of a number of slots, I think that what we can do is to reduce the duration of the plenary. I don't think that this is something that will create major hurts if it's made for everybody, because in this case, we will show equal attention to all the different topics and without creating artificial priorities. Thank you.
Thank you, Giacomo. If I could ask people to just really be quite succinct in their comments as well, that will help us move forward. We have the Council of Europe next.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I think we're all saying very much the same thing, which is that these sessions are the main sessions, therefore they're the signposts of the Internet Governance Forum. When it comes to looking at the whole event, you will look at those main sessions and say to yourself, you know, what is this event about? And so I think we're getting lost in terms of the titles. That all of the sessions are very interesting and very engaging, but the titles don't communicate what they mean. I think then we need to spend time, maybe it's not for this group, to understand what we're trying to communicate, to explain, exchange on. you know, what's the purpose of a main session? Is it to complement the workshops, which are more technical? Are they there to bring people together and be more general but meaningful? I feel like they're the glue between the workshops, and therefore they have to hit, they have to go higher, but they have to be meaningful. So they need to be curated. They need attention to media. You know, are they the spaces where the media are going to come together and look and see what's happening? Are they going to be technical? So I feel like there's a need for, you know, a media curation needs to be put onto the workshop proposals, onto the proposals for titles. The titles are very general and don't mean a lot to me in my personal opinion. I understand them. I understand the merits. But they need to be, I think, who is the audience? You can't control the audience. So therefore, it needs to be, I think, more narrow. I think it would be better to ask questions or to have a generic part and a question. So at least when we go into that session, we know we're going to ask a question, it's specific, and we come out maybe with that question answered. So I would really like to see attention to, you know, either a generic part but also a question and made more narrow. I asked the question whether the duration of different main sessions, does it have to be 1, 2 hours or 3 hours? Can it be shorter? Because some can be shorter. And I think, you know, of course, new entrants is key. Youth are a new entrant, one could say. So, you know, are we spending enough time on the new entrants in terms of these main sessions? And the last point I would say is that if we're going to talk about trade agreements, then we need the right people in the room. Are the right people going to be in the room for that? I mean, if you go into that session and trade doesn't have WTO, if you go into a session which involves sub-jurisdiction and you don't have people involved in international law, then there's a mismatch between what we're trying to achieve. Thank you.
No, I agree. It's clear, has been said several times, that whatever ones we decide to go with are going to need a lot more shaping. And so if we could not repeat that point, that would help us to move forward. Miguel, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. Just wanted to show my support for Liesl and Flavio's proposal to give an upgrade to the 179. And also to Marilyn and Jandir's proposal for the main session. And also, I would like to explore the possibility to give an upgrade to another proposals in order to cover all the aspects that were not covered, like, for example, Internet of Things and stuff, to look through the proposals and check whether there's one we can upgrade. Okay.
Thank you, Miguel. Elizabeth, you have the floor.
Thank you very much. I actually haven't had a chance, neither my co-organizer or I, to present our main session yet, so I'd like to do that if you will. Before I do that, I just wanted to address some of the different points that were made. So I would support your proposal about the dynamic coalitions and appreciate that. I would like to support the expression by Peter and some other members regarding Proposal 1. And before the lunch break, Mike was speaking about the trade session, and I would say that I share those concerns that he expressed, and this idea that perhaps the workshops that are already covering the topic would be sufficient for that one. So regarding the proposal that I put forward with Hossam, and I'll just clarify that while Hossam is indeed a business person at the outset, he's actually such a good business person that the Egyptian government said, please come and help us. And so he's working for the Egyptian cabinet at the moment. And so this proposal is actually business and government putting it forward together with other stakeholders. I have outlined in the proposal for those of you who may have missed it, that we, while putting forward the ideas here together, fully intend to develop a small committee of diverse colleagues from other stakeholder groups who would work with us to execute the session to identify the right stakeholders and ensure that the usual balance is there. We just didn't have time to do all that work ahead of the proposal. So just to describe a little bit what it is about, because I think there's also a little confusion about what it is and what it isn't. I wanted to reference the very good guidelines that we were given in developing a proposal for a main session. I'm just going to top line them because I think it's important that we see them in our head. So the contemporary and relevant framework. Obviously, we chose
this topic with the sustainable development overarching idea, but then also building in the main theme of inclusivity. And I'll elaborate a little bit more on that, but this is a really important part that is the how we get specific, because obviously sustainable development is pretty much everything. As we know, by the 2030 agenda, it covers off the global vision for the future. So whether our session is 90 minutes or 3 hours, none of us can possibly do that. So what we are looking at here is to build on the foundations that were started in the discussion of the sustainable development goals and the internet economy last year. And that is not at all to say to repeat. That is to say that we had a very good session last year with 3 hours that were filled to the point that, frankly, I was the remote participation moderator, and I thought 3 hours is going to feel really long. And in the end of the session, it felt like we could still talk for a lot longer. And as a result of that, there were actually 3 developing country governments that wanted to talk longer, talk locally, and talk about this. So I think when we think about the goals for our proposal, I flag those things because I think that's what we're trying to do in the contents and substance session, is be appealing to developing countries to be relevant in the global context and then get specific into the internet and the role of internet governance and the role of ICTs in facilitating the progress that we want to make. So there are 3 questions that we want to drill down more specifically into during this session. We will be inviting youth to participate and speak at this session, so that component will actually be included. We will have some research papers that I'll let Hossam speak more specifically about those that will be part of it. And so the 3 buckets that we want to look at were the knowledge for community development. And so this is considering the role of education and the policies of education and training and the challenge of illiteracy and integrating digital education into leveraging internet for inclusive development. And again, this is about taking the sustainable development goal of ensuring quality education, fair comprehension, comprehensive, and promote life learning opportunities, and then linking it to the internet, the economy, but also inclusion, because our analysis and our understanding from last year's session is that if we don't make that real, and I think it's why everyone agreed to a main overarching theme of inclusion, if we don't make that real, we can give access all we want, and we will not actually have an effective and impactful internet. So then there's the youth and employment part, and I won't elaborate in detail on that. I will just let you review and look at the proposal. But this makes the link again between
incubating.
Yes, thank you. incubating the ideas and actually having them realized in terms of small and medium enterprises and other experiences. And then I think the other point I wanted to make, and I know Hossam will speak, so I'll let you elaborate on a few of them, is that in addition, so we'll be working with the Egyptian government, and the support and engagement in this issue goes right up to the top of that. We also have the World Bank interested in working with us. And I think that's all I need to say about that for now. I'll leave Hossam to say the rest.
Okay, that was quite a thorough introduction. So, Hossam, if there's a key point that you think that's missing, perhaps you could cover it, and otherwise we'll move on. So, Hossam, you have the floor.
Thank you. Well, a lot has been said by Elizabeth, but just to make sure that the main objective of this main session is to talk about inclusion within the Sustainable Development Goals. And inclusion is not just for disabled people, but inclusion for marginalized people, for remote areas. What we have seen in our developing world is that while sometimes we can be doing very good GDP growth, but then this is not reflected all over the countries. And this caused problem. So we want to show that using internet and proper internet governance, we can help having proper inclusion of marginalized people. And for that, we have I have the support of the Prime Minister of Egypt for that session. We have support of sub-intergovernmental organizations. We will bring youth to speak from their own point of view about inclusion in sustainable development and about how to use internet to achieve this properly. And we will ahead of time, some of the researchers will be providing research papers and will be doing some polling as well in the countries. We'll bring some also colleagues from the African continents to do the same so that we can really bring a very practical showcasing of what can be done in what we are saying. So it's really policy making for the short term for making sure we achieve inclusion using internet. Thank you.
Thank you, Hossam. I have about seven people left in the queue that I drew the line under before, so we'll go through them quite quickly and then, again, just try and lay out the next steps. The next two speakers are Jivan and then Salah.
Thank you. I think there's quite a few people mentioned that perhaps there are several things that we should be, that we should include. And one of them is the Internet of Things. Internet of Things kept on coming up, and I, it's unfortunate. Like I would have wanted to, but I didn't get a chance to write a main session proposal on that. And I, if I did, I would have done it on that. So not to throw a wrench in the machine right now and propose a new one. Just thinking of how it can be included in some of the existing proposals. But I, so one is the. You know, in the connecting the next billion, perhaps put a part of the conversation on the Internet of Things and think about it so that it is a set part of the program that will be discussed in that. Also, the shaping the future of Internet governance, and perhaps as Christina mentioned, if the focus is slightly shifted into shaping the future of the Internet and its governance now. I think that also that it's important that all of these, as we get them to be better, and I think do think that all of them need some work to get them, they need to focus on a key question, because all of them somehow are a bit too broad. That's when things are relevant. And if it is for the Internet of Things, I think that trust is the key thing that is, that needs to be discussed as we open this can of worms. Or blessing to humanity, or whatever it is, or however it manifests, I think that trust issues will be rising more and more. So that would be the kind of a part of the question that I would put on IoT. Now, just a very short show of support to what Lee has said in terms of a general comment on what main sessions are. Main sessions really should be the bubbling up of main problems. It is our MAG's way of saying to the world or whatever, whoever listens, this is important, this requires attention, this is what smart people who have been focused on this issue think about it. Let's everyone invite to and some next steps. So I think that we really have to be careful with the main sessions and to really make it interesting and really try to bring in the media and communication, all communication aspects that we talk about, and focusing on the main sessions because the IGF can be presented to the world through the main sessions. So I don't know if we're going to finish at all main session discussion today, but I think this we really have to get it right.
No, I agree we have to get it right. One of the other comments that came up in a side conversation is maybe we have some that are main sessions that do just what you and Juan and folks have said, and maybe the others are labeled intersessional work or a community session or something if we really feel that there's a different distinction at the end of the day. So I think we have a lot of kind of things we can play with to maybe really highlight those sessions that we think are really important to the future. So the next few speakers, again, if you joined the queue after I said it was closed, you know who you are. but the next ones that I have in the queue are Salah, Raphael, and Avri, and then there's a few more after that. So Salah, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. Hi, everybody. We can all relax now. I just wanted to say happy birthday, Giacomo. And back to business. In terms of the main sessions, I just wanted to maybe take us on a different tangent a bit and perhaps think about, you know, how this is the first IGF that sort of represents the next generation or the next breed. It's not just, you know, it's not just a jump from, say, Samsung 5 to Samsung 6 to Samsung 7. This is sort of like an evolution. And it's sort of, and you know, the MEG, in terms of setting the agenda, and I'd like to write on what Jivan and what Lee was saying, this is our opportunity to set the agenda. And, you know, despite the polarizations, and acknowledge it exists, and despite the fact that you've got, diversity, I think that diversity is our strength. And one of the biggest strengths that I find is, if you look at a lot of people that are proposing the sessions, the main sessions, with the exception of the first one, correct me if I'm wrong, is the first one not here, right? The rest are here, at least. Co-proposers. So if you take a look at that, we have the opportunity to actually create, you know, instead of like standalone sessions, but have one major theme where, you know, everyone builds up to the idea or the agenda that we as a MEG would like for the world to see, or where we want to take the IGF to set the tone, as what Jivan was sort of saying. And not so much just the tone. I'm not sure if you guys play the guitar. You know how you have, maybe this is a bad example, but a tuning fork. How when you set a tuning fork and you set a frequency, it sort of calibrates the other instruments. And so in a time where internet governance is heavily polarized, there's so many discussions, I think the common thing that brings everybody together, despite the polarizations, despite the diversity, is things like we want to see change and positive change. We want to see development. So tying it back to the Sustainable Development Goals, tying it back to something that can universalize into concrete, tangible outcomes, I would like to just make the first to say that priority should be given to what the CSTD working group, their outputs in terms of the dynamic coalitions, the best practice forums, and also priority should be also given to the NRIs, like the voices from the diverse groups, and also in terms of the other workshop proposals, they're all really, really brilliant, from the incubating of businesses, looking at examples in the developing region, from what Liesl was sort of saying, and Flavio in terms of getting, you know, unheard voices. But if we can get a neutral, you know, somebody to sort of bring all these people together, to for them to tailor their session proposals in a way where it's building up to a central theme, you know what I mean? Instead of just, that would be really great. Anyway, I hope I made my point clear.
Thank you, Sala. Rafael, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I'll be very brief. I just wanted, first of all, to echo Peter's concerns with regards to proposal number one. And secondly, I wanted to express my support for Flavio and Liesl's proposal, which I really like the idea of getting together youth and pioneers in order to draw conclusions and learn lessons or to build upon in the future. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for some very useful and concise input. Avri, you have the floor.
Thank you. Avri speaking. First of all, in terms of the dynamic coalition, I see a certain logic in what's being proposed. I'll take it back, you know, and talk to the dynamic coalitions to see what can be worked out. Certainly the idea of coming up with a better title than just dynamic coalitions is probably really good advice. In terms of the other ones, I wanted to just quick, some, I have similar comments to a lot of people on number one. I'm concerned about the sustainable development, not because of the topic, but because it almost feels like we're trying to boil the ocean in that one, that it's really hard to get hands around it. And so I know we're going to be talking about that, but that's really one of the big concerns I have. The trade agreements, I have a concern about the internet governance relationship and having the right people in the room. And so I'm not quite sure that I see how that one fits in. The shaping of the future of the internet, that sounds like a really good idea with the youth. Do we have to be careful about how many MAG members we have actually as panelists on main session? I don't know where we stand on that, but when I heard about the two distinguished members of MAG on it, I just wanted to... Okay, maybe I misunderstood, or maybe I've got something backwards. But anyway, and I really wanted to speak out strongly in terms of the economic, social, and cultural rights, because that is a well-formed session, and it is a critical subject for us to deal with. Thanks.
Great. Thank you, Aubrey. These are very helpful comments. Liesl, you have the floor.
Thank you. I'll try to be brief, but try to capture a few things that struck me. First, on general comments, there have been several proposals, well, not really proposals because they've been brought up in the room, but for covering main sessions on things like trade, cybersecurity, and IoT were really the three I captured. And I really, really appreciate Jivan's comments about if not its own main session, then capturing the content or the issue within the main sessions that are out there. I think not only is that a more dispersed way and perhaps more exciting way to deal with whatever the issue is, whether it's trade, cybersecurity, and IoT, in across the main sessions where they're relevant and where they can bring salient parts of the discussion to the debate. But I think it also avoids one thing that I think we've seen in the past, and maybe this is my own experience with organizing main sessions a couple times with MAG members and with Lee from COE, where we were desperately trying not to make the main session on the topic, where there were several workshops, not be just duplicative or redundant or report outs. So I'm actually very excited about the idea of not having necessarily main sessions that are dedicated solely to an issue that we have seven or six or more great workshops on, where the challenge would be to make them distinct or different in some way. So I think that that's a great suggestion, Jivan. So thank you for covering that in a way that's better than I'm just doing.
I love seeing my name.
I was like, Jivan, yay. My second comment is to Lee's comment about making the workshops more attractive and being curated. And I think he's capturing something that we're in, where we are in the process, which was the proposal for the workshops. And I commend everybody back to the workshop guidelines, which do address things like social media and I don't think we use the word marketing, but promoting and making them exciting. And so I commend people as they're organizing the workshops between now and the IGF. They have an opportunity to do that, and I think his recommendations were well on point there. On that note, I just want to refer people back to the guidelines again, because there was one specific, we had a conversation earlier about building on past discussions from other IGFs, and that is indeed one of the guidelines, guideline of principle 6 in the workshop guidelines. So to the extent that that can be combined with the marketing and the excitement aspect of the main sessions, whatever they may be, I think that's great. I totally think we're heading in a better direction with regard to the DCs and the NRIs with regard to pulling out the organizational aspects of those discussions from the main session and trying to make the main session itself more robust and exciting, and I think some of the comments we're hearing will really help with that. So to the extent that they can cover some of these aspects, that would be great. In addition to the name change, perhaps we all can probably think about name changes that might be more exciting. Then last, I'd take a moment to address the proposal for upgrading workshop 179 to the main session. There's been some really good suggestions for that, and I just want to cover a couple things. First, I hesitate to call it just a youth session, because I think one thing that was attractive to it for me was that it wasn't a youth-focused session. It was a session on important topics that had youth in it. So I'd really hate to use that abbreviation for it. I don't know how the organizers feel about it, but that was my reaction. So, because I don't want it to appear like it's the only youth session or that youth should be directed there. They should be interspersed throughout. So thank you to Flavio for your further explanation about the youth participants and those that are engaged in the development of the workshop. And I think that addressed Marilyn's concern in her note to me. I hope that, and certainly I think as if it is accepted, I imagine that the workshop organizers and the MAG co-organizers that will be helping to curate it between now and the IGF will take, you know, as guided in the guidelines, take input from the community to, you know, raise the salient questions, market it, promote it in the ways that people have talked about here and will continue to do so. Thank you.
Thank you, Liesl. I have four more people in the queue before we move to the next topic. And Sally, you had earlier referenced the first proposal. In fact, Mogino is here. He did introduce the proposal earlier. He is also the next in the queue. And I think at this point, when I read, there have been seven strong, statements with respect that they just didn't think that proposal was ready for a main session or appropriate for a main session. I don't think it's fair to let Mogino take the floor and not kind of indicate that to him just now. So you do have the floor, sir. And if there's anything final you'd like to say with that, I think there's been no one else who has spoken out in support of the proposal. And as I said, seven quite strong comments that they thought it just wasn't ready or appropriate yet. So you have the floor, sir. Indonesia.
Okay, thank you. I would like to describe the title number one, towards an interoperable global intranet network, solving current problems on cyber jurisdiction. It is the result of our discussion involving the national multi-stakeholder in internet and also international multi-stakeholder organization, both discussion and then come up with one kind of this title where we have to describe or we have to discuss with all of the multi-stakeholder in the session involving how the future of the intranet network, where every country can set up their own intranet under their own national law, and also those intranet network can carry out interoperability with all other intranet network, and also several things that can be solved within the discussion. That's why I try to propose this kind of topic so we can discuss what is the problem and how to solve this problem with international multi-stakeholder organization. Thank you.
Thank you, Mogino. So I have Marcus, an online participant, and Ephraim, you were in the queue immediately then. You've dropped out again, but I'm just wondering if that's a mistake. If you'd like to be in the queue, you will be our final speaker on this topic. So Marcus, you have the floor.
Thank you, Lynn. I'm not sure whether it's appropriate for me to comment on what Mogino just said on proposal number one. I listened with great interest, but I share personally and also in my capacity as member of the board of ICANN some of the concerns expressed before. It's very interesting, but I think the proposal may not be mature enough for a main session as it has not been discussed widely before. And I wonder whether it might not be possible to turn it into an open forum where the Indonesian community can explain their discussions. That's just a thought. But my comment was essentially back to the dynamic coalitions and to build on what Avery says. Yes, of course, we'll go back to the dynamic coalitions. And I think what you proposed to split it into two may actually work. There is need for a space for them to discuss horizontal issues, but there seems to be a misunderstanding. What they propose as horizontal issues are not just organizational issues, but broader issues that are of common interest, and they relate also to the interaction with the broader community. And that's why it is important to do that in a setting where as many people as possible will participate. And I do understand that many members of the community have concerns about the dynamic coalitions, which sometimes are seen as a small special interest groups. And that's why it is important to get the input. And we had that when we had a consultation at the last MAG meeting. And it's important for the dynamic coalitions also to hear concerns other people may have and to take it on board. It is, after all, an important part of the community going forward and to make sure that they are integrated. But do I take it that your proposal is to give them two-hour main session and then a separate session where they would also have interpretation and could discuss these horizontal issues?
I think the proposal earlier was to give them a separate workshop slot, which would have interpretation for what we had previously called the horizontal issues, I guess. And then I think it was actually a 90-minute slot if we were to split a three-hour slot into two. But I think there's some more refinement to be done on these proposals in any case. But at this point, it would be a 90-minute slot as a main session in the large room with full interpretation and a two-hour slot in another room with interpretation into three languages. We have an online participant, Anya.
Yes, I will read briefly a comment from Alejandra Ramuspe, and then later if we can give the floor to Virat. So reading a comment from Alejandra, I want to support assessing the role of IG in SDGs, shaping the future of internet governance, and national and regional IGF initiatives. And now, Virat.
There's a slight problem in the room here. I think there's a delay that's being broadcast back through the mic, so let's give it a moment. Anya, did you get the full comment in?
No, I didn't hear it.
Okay, well, we'll come back.
Can I speak now?
Okay.
Can you hear me?
Please go ahead, Virat. And if you could,
can you hear me?
We need to move on to the next
topic. I'm speaking.
We can hear you, Virat.
Can you hear me now?
Yes. Virat, we can hear you.
Okay,
please
speak. Thank you. I just wanted to, again, my favorite, everybody else has, but as the colleague of the working group, I just wanted to, if you could just mute me because I'm getting a lot of sound back. The comment we made earlier that these are plenary sessions. I just wanted to advise everybody in the room, these are not plenary sessions if plenary is understood as the only unique sessions being held. Every single main session competes with between 16 workshops or open forums simultaneously. The only plenaries are closing and opening. So these are not plenaries by any stretch of imagination, just a larger room, perhaps. So just please keep that in mind. Secondly, we have guidelines which can help us select, because everybody who's provided main session proposals was informed that the selection criteria is in the guidelines. So if you run over the number that we can accommodate, we should use the guidelines, we should put them to use. And that will help separate proposals one from the other. The third point is, to the best of my understanding, most of the, till now at least, the main session proposals have been submitted by MAG members. So if there are, this time I think there are some proposals or one by non-MAG members. So the MAG must make a decision on whether you want to open this door, because once you create a precedent in future years, then you will have a lot of main session proposals coming from the community, which will have to be accommodated along with those from the MAG. So we'll need to make that decision. Unless I'm wrong, I don't think main sessions have come from outside the MAG in the past, except, of course, Dynamic Coalitions and BPF, which represent the MAG. And finally, if we can, just two numbers I'll leave with you. If we can zero down on seven main sessions, you can still have 5 3-hour sessions, 1 2-hour session, and 1 90-minute session. If you zero down on eight, you can have 4 3-hour sessions, 2 sessions for 2 hours each, and 2 for 90 minutes. You can find a special room large enough to take forward the Dynamic Coalition BPF intersessional work through a short session at the main room. But I think those are very important, and if we can arrange for translation, call them special sessions here, special space. So I think we'll have to like open and create some space for these two or three important pieces of work which happen throughout the year. So we might want to think innovatively, starting this one, on how to accommodate those. And that we can get down the main sessions to perhaps seven and accommodate them reasonably well. Thank you.
Thank you, Virat. And thank you for staying with us so very, very late. In fact, now it's early in the morning in India, so thank you. Ephraim is the last speaker on this, and then I'm going to try and underline where I think we are. And we'll quickly move to the back to the workshop selection process. Ephraim, you have the floor.
Hi, this is Ephraim. First of all, I would like to appreciate every effort to include young people, and not just young people, but every disadvantaged group and the marginalized. So just to reemphasize that it's good for us to have that session and to look for support. And not just that, but to build on to conversation which we started last year, during the MAG meeting in Geneva in the middle of the year, about like having an online resource for people to reach out, because some of the things that people have said in the past when we say, why don't you include young people to this discussion, is that we don't know the young people. The YCIG had come up with the YCIG is the Youth Dynamic Coalition on Youth. They had come up with an online resource where young people's names who had offered themselves to participate in this can be involved in. And we'd like just to reshare that and request if the Secretariat can also share that as part of the recommendations, in especially sessions which you've said that they need to include youth. But this, if possible, should be shared with all people. And then also to build on to Flavia's comments about young people, and we just appreciate the kind of input from the CGIBR last year. But before then, if you remember 2014, during the Taking Stock main session, there was a statistic which I can't verify, but it was quoted that the percentage back then, before 2014, it was 3%. Last year, CGIBR did a good thing by the kind of program, and this year something similar is coming up. I've been talking to our Latin American colleagues, but then what is the sustainability of this? That's why it goes back to this session, like trying to, when this moves to Africa or to other countries, the IGF, how do we find sustainable mechanisms to not just inclusion of them, but inclusion of the marginalized people? This is a discussion which I would be interested in supporting the main session to have that kind of discussion. Sustainability. How do we bring all these efforts together? The State Department, I would like just to appreciate, they have the YALI program and Young Africa Leadership Initiative program, which of late they've been involved in so many activities. How do we bring all these voices together, ISOC Ambassadors Program, and all these programs, how do we bring them and share best practices? This is some of the discussions we'd want us to have. And then lastly, I would also like to support the idea of the social economic rights main session. Thank you.
Thank you, Ephraim. Let me try and capture where I think we are on the main sessions. Also address one of the points Virat mentioned. We did have a discussion this morning about the trade panel, and Renata, in fact, mentioned that she and I believe another MAG member actually were co-organizers as well. It's just when they went to put their names on the slot, it was too late or something. I think that's, you know, a little bit, we haven't been all that clear on whether or not we would allow submissions from non-MAG members. So at this point, I think given the discussion we've had on it, it's in the mix. We can clarify for next year what we'd like to do with them, but I think it's in the mix to determine whether or not we go forward with it. What I heard was that for the first proposal, Indonesia, there's been significant concerns about including that as a main session in terms of its, I guess, readiness or appropriateness, and nobody other than the proposer speaking for it. So I'd like to leave it to Indonesia, Mojino, and the Secretariat, perhaps, to see whether or not there's a workshop slot or an open forum or something, which clearly, as a previous host of the IGF, you're quite entitled to, and see if we can accommodate it that way. So I think where we are at the moment is we have one three-hour slot for the Next Billion and Best Practice Forums. I think we've agreed that there's one three-hour slot for the NRIs. I think we've agreed that the Dynamic Coalition people will take back to the Dynamic Coalition community the notion that they would be given a two-hour slot with interpretation for the horizontal set of discussions. And at this point in time, it's a potential of a 90-minute, possibly two-hour, but more likely it would be 90-minute if it was going to be a full main session. We do have some other flexibility, of course, with some other large rooms, which would have interpretation in three languages. So I think there's some things we can play with. That leaves, there was sort of a significant amount of support for all of the other proposals. That would be the workshop proposal 179 upgraded, the SDG proposal, the sustainable development proposal, and the economic, social, and cultural proposal. The trade proposal, notwithstanding what I said a moment ago, has had four, you know, quite strong comments expressing concern and one supporting it. I don't know if the room is ready very quickly to come to a decision on the trade and whether or not that goes forward or we bring that forward to the MAG, but that is the only one that I think is at this point questionable as to whether we continue to bring it forward or we suggest that it's not appropriate for a main session. But we really don't have a lot of time, so if I'll kind of look around the room and ask for any comments from the online participants as well with respect to whether you think we are ready to close on that proposal going forward or staying in the mix, or whether or not we move it forward. So let me just ask quickly, do people feel that we're ready to take a decision on whether it stays in the mix or go forward? This is the trade proposal, trade agreements in the internet. So the ones that are definitely in, only at this point in time, are the Best Practice Forum and Connecting and Enabling the Next Billion, and the NRI, and some type of dynamic coalition session, primarily because they were all agreed at the last MAG meeting. The other proposals, the Sustainable Development, Internet Inclusive Growth, the third one on the table, the whatever sixth one in the table, the Shaping the Future of the Internet, the upgraded workshop proposal 179, and the economic, social, and cultural, and the SDGs are the four that have had fairly significant support in the room, which would imply they're going forward with some significant additional discussion on how we make them everything they can be. The one that I think did not is somewhere in a gray area is a trade. And I said, by my calculations, there were four commenting against it and one commenting for it if they weren't, in fact, a proposer. So the question in front of us just right now, really quickly, is the room ready to say the trade proposal goes forward as a main session or it does not? Are we ready to take that decision now? So I see lots of heads nodding around the room for those that are participating online. I would say by the readings here that there's not support in the room for that to go forward. So let me ask if there's anybody that wants to argue to the contrary or position to the contrary. Oh, Renata, sorry, you have the floor.
Yes. I would like to address the issue of supporting the MAG members supporting the main session. There is a digital trade coalition. So there is a civil society coalition on digital economy, and I am part of it. And so is Jeremy Malcolm and many other civil society activists who used to be MAG members and so on. And we do this proposal with many intergovernmental organizations, so IGF, Trade and Development, UNCTAD, and many other intergovernmental organizations. So this is a proposal which indeed also shows up, this theme, in many workshops, but it's by many different civil society groups. And when I spoke with Omar, Omar was in the middle of trying to get his visa to the meeting, which he did not succeed to get. So that's why he is not here. Omar from Afghanistan, private sector. And we were finishing up the talk on this proposal to send it to the MAG, as well as organizing the many different civil society groups for the workshop proposals. I would once more stress that this is a digital economy issue. So having this theme in the discussions is very important. I do understand points made that when we are referring to the TPP, we are referring to countries that are in the Trans-Pacific Agreement. So neither Brazil or Afghanistan is there, but we do support this proposal because we also think that it relates to other international concerns, such as intellectual property, censorship, and so on. This would be my comment regarding to the trade session. As you have also said, you all have said, there are many other proposals related to this issue. It would be important that they get represented. I would like to address another comment on the youth session. There are many groups also, there are many different youth coalitions, and those participants are already integrated in these many different groups. So this is a proposal that comes with an array of projects attached to it. So I would really recommend considering it in a broader view. And I would also express support for the ESCR main session. Since human rights was also a theme that was really analyzed to be the IGF 2016 main theme, this would be an interesting main session to move forward. This would be it.
Thank you, Renata, for all your comments. I think I still have to lean if I read the sense of the room to that proposal not going forward as a main session proposal. And I don't know if it would be appropriate to look at it and see whether or not there's some way to take some of the components of that and put it in some of the other programs, which I think you were commenting on. So if I can underline that and we move forward from that perspective, so the trade main session proposal at this point is not going forward as a main session proposal either. There's a couple of people in the queue. Is it specific to this point? Because we really do need to move to the workshop proposals. So, Jivan, you have the floor.
No, I mean, if the feeling in the room is strong that this shouldn't be included, then okay. But there is something in that. There is something in trade that we should really open up and perhaps. And what I wanted to say is that, like, my feeling with all of them are somehow, it's like I don't have a very good feeling that these, you know, like all of them require a lot of work. And perhaps if we open it up for another week so that everyone can kind of reshape their own proposal based on the discussions here, of course, that would open up perhaps the possibility of one more or other being included and to organize an online meeting just on main sessions. I don't get a feeling that we're there to make the decision on main sessions at the moment. Just personal feeling, but yeah.
So I don't think it would be fair to open it up for new. I think that doesn't give credit to all the work that everybody's done and the timelines. I think the sessions that are still in, everybody has freely said need significant more work, so they're not necessarily in. They're ones we're carrying forward for further. I mean, I suspect they'll be in once we continue to improve upon them, with the exception of the trade and the first workshop proposal, I think are the two that we're definitely not moving forward as a main session. So I think there's agreement for that when I look across the room. I see lots of heads nodding. Is there anybody who believes that I've captured it incorrectly? Which is entirely possible. Okay, then So Liesl has a clarification, Jack, and then we're going to move on.
Thank you, Chair, and it's really a clerical point. If workshop number 179 is being upgraded into a main session, then that leaves an open slot for a workshop. So, but it was not the intention to have a workshop and the main session on the same thing, anyway, just want to clear that up.
That was a given.
I know.
I'm just trying to make it a little light. Jack, you have the floor.
Thanks, Chair. I think there is something about the trade topic, given the fact that there are quite a lot of workshop proposals that's come on that. But I also really do appreciate the sense that maybe as a main session in the competing space that it might not work so well. But I would recommend thinking about how this can be integrated into the other main session so that it is also barely being raised at that platform and at that level. And since I have some space, if I can just say something around 179, I think it's a great idea, but what I love about it is actually the same sentiment that Liesl was saying. It's that it's having different people of different generations sitting in the same table having a conversation rather than sort of looking at it as an identity-led kind of a session, but more like, you know, this is about the future of the internet and let's have,
So I think we're done with the main session. People, please, I've tried to close this queue three times. I now have a queue of five people and a few more people in the room asking for some short, and we need to close on the workshop selection process. I have online and Marilyn Cade and Mike Nelson in the queue. So online participant, please, people need to keep it really short. It is not possible to do workshop selection over the course of the summer through mail and doodle poll and virtual meetings. We need to move to that quickly. The main sessions we can continue in the virtual meetings much more easily. I do want to give time to the online participant.
So really briefly, I'm going to read just the comments. Renata supports economic, social, and cultural rights session. And Ginger prefers to drop the trade session since we are aiming for the consensus of all MEG members, even the online. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Ginger. Marilyn, you have the floor.
Thank
Chair, would you just, you don't need to do it now, you could even do it in writing, but when you say that the proposal such as the one from the NRIs, et cetera, needs substantive improvement of work, could you clarify online, please, what that means? Because that session has already been heavily, heavily worked by the NRIs. I'm sure they're happy to do a lot more, right, Sala? We're always happy to do more.
Okay. I didn't pull the NRIs out quickly. I said, as a general comment, most of the comments have said that we need to do more with the main sessions, not just on the main sessions, but also how they're seen and promoted. And so it wasn't anything more specific than that. So with a deep breath... and I'm not quite sure how we close out the day here, and we do have a hard stop at 6 o'clock for a number of reasons. There was quite a long list of proposals that people were asked to go away and take another look at over lunch. There was also a very useful Google Doc that was started on the basis of the clusters that had been identified yesterday. I haven't had time to check, so I don't know what's happened to the Google Doc in the last few hours or so. We have about 8 more slots, roughly 8 to 10, that we can fill in to get to the program of 100. Now, Chengatai also says that, you know, occasionally some workshops drop out or they're not there. So if we were to identify a few more as alternates, that would be good for the Secretariat in terms of backfilling some of those. The task in front of us, and we literally have about an hour and 15 minutes, and we should have some time at the end to wrap up. And by saying that, that means we're not getting through the follow-up on any remaining questions on any of the intersessional work. And there was a request from a couple of the NRIs to give some short interjections on their work, which I certainly would like to accommodate if we can. If not, perhaps they could submit something in writing and send it to the MAG list. And Marilyn is shaking her head yes, as that would be with apologies to them, because it's always good to hear the voices and see the faces and the updates. And if we get to the workshop selection quickly enough, maybe we'll get there. So the workshop selection process, we had two kind of last buckets going. One was the long list of items which we had put forward, which had some support in the room. And then there was a cluster document. If we could go through the long list that was put in front of the room, my feeling when I looked at the cluster document at lunchtime is that the cluster document, again, had two purposes. People said there's a lot of similar topics. We should look at them and understand whether or not there's too much redundancy, duplication, opportunities for merger, that sort of thing. I think that's a more substantive piece of work. And I saw some really good work, again, happening in the Google Docs, which was trying to look at which ones were already accepted, which ones had a regional difference, and those sorts of things. That might be something we can take offline and try in advance if it means some more rationalization. But for the moment, what I'd like to do right now, I think, with everybody's, I guess, support, would be to work through the list. And what we're looking for here, I think, are just short comments of you believe proposals X, Y, and Z should be included, or it's an opportunity for merger, or if you have a strong objection to. And again, we're trying to get from that list of, I think, was 15 or 20 proposals till about 10 that we would actually rule as in towards our goal of 100. Is that process clear? So, Jivan, you're in the queue.
So, based on the table that was provided by Chengatai on the clustered, I looked at the IoT ones. And within that group, there were number 35, 123, 131, 170, 181, and 188. So
these are the ones in the cluster, or?
So these are the ones that are originally in the cluster. So I'm going deductively, starting at the top. Or an inverted pyramid. 131 is not really on IoT, so it automatically disqualifies, at least from what I looked at. If it really is 131, perhaps it was a mistake that was put there, but that's not IoT. 123 is topical, but the idea is not well developed. So it is number 242 on the list of all the rated ones. It's on
So 123 was unique cybersecurity challenges on IoT. It's a very topical issue, but the idea of whoever it was proposed didn't really develop it. It's proposed as a birds of a feather, which indicates that perhaps it could be fitted into something else. But by itself, it's really, as I said, number 242 out of all of them. So we're left with 35 and 188. Of those, both were well developed within themselves. So I would leave them separate, and they're within the 85 that we've already identified to be workshops on their own. And the remaining ones are 170 and 181. Both are, from what I can see from this latest table, outside of the 85 that have been included, or whatever, 90, I don't know what number we're at. So they're not within it, correct me if I'm wrong. They have technical focus and a regulatory one as well. They're number 106 and number 90 from, so there is an incentive to merge. They're both outside of it, so there could be an incentive. So the proposal on IoT from within the group that was proposed is to take out 131, to take out 123, leave 35 and 188 as workshops that can be organized on their own, and perhaps propose to merge 170 and 181.
Okay, thank you, Javon. That was very clear. Renata, you have the floor.
Yes, I would just like to discuss the issue of algorithms that I discovered deep buried in big data cluster, which I already mentioned that I've proposed a few merges specifically about big data in cities and sustainable cities. So 68 and 69, which are highly ranked, and 187. So I would again discuss this merger, put forward this merger idea. But the issue of algorithms, it's amazing how few proposals came up, and this is such an important issue for the theme of IGF 2016. We all live our lives in social networks and in platforms which are defined by algorithms, and workshop 2042, which directly relates algorithms to human rights, has got a low rating, and it could be merged with 42. And so it's 242, could be merged with number 42, and also many, any other of the big data workshops, so 69, 58 would be interesting to merge. But 232 and 42 would definitely be a recommendation, and a thing that needs to be present in IGF 2016, in my opinion, is algorithms.
Thank you, Renata. Juan, you have the floor.
I'm a little bit lost. Are we commenting in the before lunch? You dictated a list of 18 possible workshops. Can I comment on that list?
Yes, that is what I think would help us.
Okay, well,
move forward. Thank you.
You sent a list of 18 possible workshops. First, I am not against any of them. I will only point out the one that I strongly support. In the same order that you gave it, I support number 16, number 52, 27, but I want to point out that it's possible merger with 88, that it's already on the list. 22 I support, but it was mentioned to merge with 36. Nobody mentioned that before. That was Giacomo's proposal to merge with 36. I think it's very easily to take the speaker from 36 and to put it in 22. 195 is the other I endorse. 271, 83, and 140. And 234. The one that I didn't mention, I'm not against them, but these are the ones that I strongly endorse. Thank you.
Thank you, Juan. Laura, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I have a very, very quick comment, actually, about two proposals that have already been accepted. In working through the collaboration document, they seemed really similar to me. I was looking at the domain name system, proposals related to the domain name system. Proposal number 75 and 173, titled Domain Name System Fragmentation, Risk and Reality, and Internet Fragmentation, Net Neutrality, respectively. From looking at the outlines, they seem pretty identical, and I think they could be merged to make room for something else. Thank you.
So we'll ask the Secretariat to look at that and take that forward, unless there's any strong objections in the room. Sala, you have the floor. Again, really interested in comments, just as Juan just did, with respect to support for the list that was put on the table by all of you. Thank you, Sala.
Thank you, Chair. First of all, I'd like to thank Flavio, Bianca, Ginger, Michael, Jack, Renata, Giacomo, Ivan, Laura, Marilyn. And if I missed anybody, it's only because I need to sleep. But and the IGF Secretariat, of course, Juan and Peter. First of all, thank you so much for putting in the time to go through the thematic clusters. By now, all MEG members should have received a link. Do you have it in your email? So if you open that link, you should have the spreadsheet. So essentially, every suggestion that was been given by any MEG member in relation to potential mergers, you can find it in that spreadsheet. And it needs to be updated to remove the five workshops that were removed today in this morning's discussions. And what we've also done is we've linked it also to the SDGs, just for those who are interested in tracking what's actually happening. So if you open the spreadsheet, you'll notice a bunch of things. One, you'll see, particularly in the second worksheet, you'll see categories that are in black font. Those ones are the IGF Secretariat categories. And then you'll see sub-themes. Now, why we've done that is because if you take a cluster like human rights, even within human rights, there's a lot of diversity. So all the group of volunteers, we've created sub-themes. They volunteered to look at clusters, to look at the sub-themes, and looked into what you had suggested in terms of mergers. So hopefully that helps make everyone's life easier. And thank you, Chair. Back to you.
Thank you, Sala. It's a very complete document and a very complete piece of work, and I think gives us some really good pointers to some things we can pull into next year's process. Again, this year, we all recognize that the time was compressed, and there wasn't a lot of processing time between the evaluations coming in and the Secretariat needing to get the ratings back out. In fact, it was just a matter of days. I think we can continue to work through these. And looking at the spreadsheet, it's so complex. I think what would help is, as Jivan just did, if there was a Jivan for the other clusters, he took responsibility for the Internet of Things. If we could get one person identified as the lead for each one of the other clusters, drive a discussion with the rest of the MAG, and if there's a recommendation that comes from a significant portion of the MAG, then I think we can look to bring it to the MAG and move it forward. I don't know how we manage to this level of complexity otherwise, if it's short solid, because I really want to go back to what I had asked everybody to do, was to take us through the list, not the clusters at this point. Mm-hmm. Sala, you have the floor.
It's still green. Oh, now I have the floor. Thank you, Chair. So in terms of people that went through the different clusters, Jack has the lead on the gender. And I think people know who they are. Bianca had the lead on the child. And she was working with Marilyn on child and youth. And others, you can just press your buzzer.
I'm going to give the floor to Chengatai in just a moment to suggest how he thinks we can move forward with the cluster exercise. Do you want a minute to think about it first? Or okay, you have the floor.
With the cluster exercise, if you identify workshops that can be merged, the IGF secretary can contact those people, and then if they merge, that means that there'll be one extra slot, correct? We are going to, as the chair suggested, we're going to have a few workshops which are on the waiting list in case some drop out, or if they merge, then they can just move up and take those spots. Is that fine?
I think the only thing we need to make sure is that if the MAG has approved a workshop in its own right, we don't want to lose that by any sort of subsequent forced merger. So I think if there's a workshop that people think has some potential or some good speakers that you think the approved workshop should be made aware of, then I think we can make them aware of that. But I don't want us to, I don't think it would be fair to start sort of forcing a merger on something that was approved in its own right. So I think that's the only caveat I put on what I understand is the exercise in front of us. So back to the list of 18 or so that you all had put on the table before we left. I have four people in the queue, Herman, Flavio, Marilyn, and Jack. So Herman, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I would like to express my support for Workshop 83. I recognize that the document really needs some development, but I think the topic of the workshop, which is improving the stakeholder representation, have a direct impact in the day-on-day operations of many of the stakeholders that we are represented here in this room today. I think it would be great if we can have this workshop included to have a candid and honest and direct discussion during the next IGF. So we have plenty of workshop here to discuss, but I'd like to specifically give support to this one. Thank you. One final moment, please. I would like to also to request that we really save some time for at the end of the meeting, as this, the agenda is stated, to discuss about the coming MAC meeting, at least to discuss the expectation of that, of that meeting. Thank you.
Thank you, Herman. We have Flavio, Meryl, and Jack, and then Yolanda. So, Flavio, you have the floor.
Thank you, Lynn. I would like to bring your attention again to workshop 195. I scanned the 85 or 90 workshops you have already accepted, and there is only two or three that deal with internet economy, very few, and none of them deals with this specific aspect of innovation. And this proposal also establishes a clear relationship to the role of innovative companies in the developing world and in relation to the sustainable development goals. So I think we should include this. It is well ranked, it's in position 123, and we have very few proposals accepted from the private sector.
Thank you, Flavio. Marilyn, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I'm going to speak in support of a merger between Workshop 25 and 271. I wrote about that. I think it also is moving in the same direction that Flavia mentioned. It is about inclusive and economic growth and development. So by bringing the Cuban proposers into 271, it would both add a unique diversity, almost case study within that, and also give us one that focuses on economic development. And then just to confirm, I will work with Bianco, but I also will offer to focus on cluster 11, which is internet and ICTs for sustainable development, in trying to look for mergers if anyone wants to work with me.
Excellent. Thank you, Marilyn. Jack, you have the floor.
Thanks, Lynn. So I looked at four different clusters: human rights, policies enabling access, multilingualism, and gender. The one on human rights, in fact, there's only three human rights sessions where the human rights was the first primary tag that is accepted. As I mentioned earlier, there really isn't any recommendations for merger because there's not a lot of duplicates in terms of our proposers as well as speakers. Where there are similar proposers, the topics are actually quite distinct. So there isn't really much recommendation around that. The only thing is that there is a clear gap around implementation of human rights in law. I think that's something that did come up. And two proposals that looks at this is proposal number 194 and 134. 134 is number 86, I think. So I'm not sure if that's... Oh, 134 actually was already accepted, so that's fine. Okay. Okay, so I'm just going to leave that. Sorry. It's 194 and 267. So both are looking at human rights on internet and law and implementation. Although one might be in, 267 might be in, I'm not sure. So just to double check. And then on policies enabling access, actually, this might not be a very useful exercise because what I should have done is looked at all of the access cluster rather than just this one, because you really had to look at access and diversity, et cetera, et cetera. So I'm not sure if it's any useful at this point just to look at that right now, except that there's quite a few that isn't really about access. It's more about Internet of Things or about freedom of expression or about Internet governance and multi-stakeholder participation. So no recommendations around that either. On multilingualism, three proposals that primarily focuses on this was accepted, and then another one that isn't quite accepted is proposal number 22, could be useful for consideration because the speakers are focused from developing contexts and is looking at local content specifically around films. So that could be considered. And then around gender, I think we've also made some decisions around this. We really just have four workshop proposals out of 15 that was accepted, and no sessions on sexuality was accepted, but after 127 and 164, I think, from the conversation earlier, I think that's been addressed. So I would support that to be still kept into the group.
Thank you, Jacques. That was obviously an incredible amount of work, so thank you. Mexico or Yolanda, but if you could light Mexico's light.
Thank you. Just a quick comment. I thought the 140 was going to be added to the list, and I just would like to put into consideration because we do a lot of work on with Latin American and the Caribbean region under ELAC. So I thought it was a good example, and also European Union has a lot of regional cooperation, and maybe we can work with the organizers of that particular workshop in having representatives from different regional organizations on the topic. Thank you.
Thank you, Yolanda. Ephraim, you have the floor.
Yeah, I just looking for more clarity. I'm looking at this document on the top 95 workshops. During the previous session, I had highlighted one workshop, 234, about linking connectivity and human rights, not just connectivity, but I don't know if I have the right version on this top 95 workshops, but I can't seem to see it here. Because in the previous selection, it was number 88.
I think there have been a couple of other people speaking out in support of 234. It was on the list of the, 18 or so workshops which we went away to evaluate at lunch. So we'll come back to that in a moment when I try and call where I think we've got some consensus. Izumi, you have the floor.
Thank you. I'm also looking at the list of top 90 workshops, and I seem to see 134 appearing twice. And I think 234 was mentioned, but it's not reflected. So I wonder if that was a typo that appearing. And also I want to make a comment about proposal 143, which is under re-examine. And I understand there was several concerns expressed about this, but this is submitted from a new proposal and also from developing country. So I think as a way forward, it would be helpful to provide advice on how to improve the workshop to be encouraging to the new people and developing country. Thank you.
No, I think that's a good comment. I think the Secretariat does try and do that on the basis of the comments that were included in the evaluations. So let me just do a quick call for whether or not there are any other MAG members that want to speak out sort of in favor of any of that list of about 20 workshops. Again, That list of 20 workshops were workshops that some MAG member put forward as thinking it was appropriate for inclusion in the list of 100, and we were looking for, of which we were looking for sort of half of them, 10. So we were looking for direction from the MAG members with respect to what are the 10 additional ones we should pull in. We're getting quite close to having some kind of commonality of view, probably around 8 of them or so. But I just want to make sure this is a clear last call for anybody who wants to come in and speak strongly in favor of any that were in that basket of 20 that were on the table. I have Indonesia and Salah in the floor. Indonesia, you have the floor.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, workshop ID number 101, it was already, there is no, not in the list. I proposed it, but it's not in the list. Thank you.
Yeah, you proposed it. It's on the list of 20, and I'm looking for a measure of support from the rest of the MAG members to move it forward. But it's on that list of 20 that went out, I assume. I'm working from my hand notes here, but 101's not on the list that went out? Flavio says it is. Okay. So, again, Mogino, it's on the list of about... Again, 20 workshops that were put on the table for further consideration. We're looking for input from the room here, and if there's significant input, it will go forward to the top 100. Failing that, it would be on the alternates list, if you will, of the next sort of 10. Okay, thank you. Salah, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. If I could just direct your attention to the back to the spreadsheet. If you look at the worksheet on clusters. So the first column, just so we're all on the same page, first column being cluster, second column being workshop selected by the MEG, although that has to be revised to remove the 5 or the 10 now, and number of workshops accepted and those not on the top 100. I'd just like to make a quick comment. There's another column there called telling, whereby, you know, there's a count, there's number of workshops accepted, there's a count in terms of the different thematic areas. So you can see that one thematic area, take for example freedom of expression, you've got 19 workshops. The list is cybersecurity 1, 5, 4, 14, and, you know, it varies. So maybe that could fine-tune the MEG's considerations in terms of how they'd like to equalize the playing field a little bit across the thematic areas. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Salah. I think we're actually looking for considerations from the individuals that are tied with driving that discussion and bringing it back to the MAG. But thank you. I'm sure they will take a closer look at it. I have an online participant and then Jack in the queue.
So just to note that Sylvia, Ginger, and Alejandra, they are supporting the workshop number 140, and Ginger is also supporting 199.
Excellent. Thank you to everyone. Jack, you have the floor.
I think the process of the cluster lead sort of walking through it would work better because some include sub-themes, some don't. So the FOE isn't exactly 19 because it includes sub-themes as well. So, yeah.
Well, I don't have anybody else in the queue at the moment. And if I just go through and of the, I didn't count them up, it's roughly 20 proposals that had come in. Let me go through the ones that have had a lot of support. That would be sort of three additional people and above coming in. The numbers that I have are 271, with a suggestion that that be merged with 275. Oh, sorry, that it be merged with 25. Proposal number 83. And proposal 140. 199, and then those that have two each are 195, 234, 52, and 11. But 11 had some conditionalities as well with respect to ensuring that we actually had African youth and women as opposed to the two males. So if I, 52, 11. Now, 119 and 16 also had some support above the individual who actually put it forward. If we wanted to add those in as well, I think that gives us the full complement that we were looking for, which should be roughly about 100 that have been specifically ruled in. Chengatai believes there is room for a few additional slots, I think, based on what he looked at before lunch because of the number of 30-minute sessions that had been approved. We obviously need to go back and look at that in some more detail, and I think that, I'm assuming that's true because I believe everything Chengatai says, would actually give us some room if some additional items are identified through the subsequent cluster work. So,
waitlisted.
and the rest of these can be waitlisted. So, I mean, I hope we have that list quite clear. If not, I can, I mean, I'm sure the transcribers caught it. I think they're doing a fantastic job. If people are okay with that, I think we'll ask the Secretariat to put out a definitive sort of Excel spreadsheet that lists those that are in. I think we shouldn't take all the others out yet because it's too useful a document to have them all in one place. But if we could reorder the spreadsheet, list all those in, which again I expect to be somewhere at about 100 proposals or so, and then they can run the statistics again so we can look at the various components of diversity, again the ones that we continue talking about, first time versus returning, developed versus developing, et cetera. And I think when we have a little more time, take a thoughtful look at it. And if there is anything that we think needs some additional balance or some additional effort or attention, then we can put a special effort behind that and pull those in. Is everybody okay with that process? Because I suspect about half of you are about to go on holiday quite soon. And so I think we'll have to rely a lot on the notes and the scribe and allow the Secretariat to go forward and take forward some of the comments they've had with respect to some of the conditionality and proposal mergers as well. So I have five people in the queue, which we'll come to, and then we can try and move to some of the other items quickly that people wanted to capture before we leave. I have Marilyn Cade, Herman, and Indonesia, and then I'll, and Julianne and Renata are the ones that are in the queue at the moment. So Marilyn, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. So I've made my proposal about 271 and 25. I'm so sorry, but I have to again ask clarification. I think your proposal to have the Secretariat give us you know, an updated list is going to be very, very helpful. I'm also, though, working, as others are, on this clustering idea and merging. And every time I get a new list of workshops, I'm trying to figure out if they're in, which I understand if they're in, I'm not trying to merge them. But if we keep taking up additional workshops until we figure out the mergers, I'm a little concerned. We might be opening a slot, but I may be negotiating merger. And in the meantime, I'm being negotiated, somebody's negotiating out from under me, so to speak. I don't mean that negatively. I'm just saying if we could really try to figure out, you know, I thought Jovan did a wonderful job of collapsing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 into a shorter list. Some of us still need to do more. Some of these have much, they've got, you know, a lot to work through. So is there a way for us to, when we consider a new list, as you just did, you gave us a new, can we flag if they're in a cluster to be merged?
So my intent was not to give you a new list. My intent was to fill in the remaining 10 slots from a list that you all gave me before lunch. Can you give Sala the mic, please?
A clarifying question, Chair. From the 90 back to 100,
Because we have the 10 extra slots.
We started the morning with roughly 82 slots or something. We finished lunch with about 90. We had 20 more proposed, of which we were looking for 10 more to get to what is meant to be sort of a firm 100. And Marilyn actually brought to mind something else, though, because there were a number of proposals for merger that I've noted here separate, but I didn't count in that final total because I don't know if, in fact, there'll be support for merging 25 and 271 or 75 and 173. I think the Secretariat actually has that proposal and will go away and look at them. And I think if they come to fruition, of which I think we know that's oftentimes difficult, we believe that there will be room in the program for them. But I think we need to allow the Secretariat some time to go away and work with the individual proposers on the issues of merger. So the Secretariat should be able to give us a final list of those that are in. And from the transcription notes or our own notes, identify those that are were specifically identified as possibilities for merger. I'm sure you'll all look very closely at what comes out. And if you think anything was not captured appropriately, we can certainly revisit it. But is that clear enough for now going forward? I think it's pretty clear that we have some, I don't know if I'd call it cleanup work or kind of capturing work to really reflect well what we've done here and what the current state is. And we'll ask the Secretary to do that and get that back out to everybody quite shortly so we can do, with perhaps is best called a sanity check and, a full diversity check. So, Herman, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. It's kind of related to the current discussion. If I remember well, last year the Secretariat reserved the right to include a few workshops if they find there were room after the evaluation of mergers and the length of the sessions. Can we expect that for this year? Nothing against that, but I think for the sake of clarity, I think it will be good to know if we can expect new workshops if the Secretariat is going to reserve the right like last year. Thank you.
I would suspect the Secretariat would like to reserve the right for some flexibility. And we can make sure that that's actually, called out appropriately as well. Indonesia, you have the floor.
Yeah. Thank you, Madam Chair. Could you move the title in the main session proposal what is rejected can be moved to either dynamic coalitions or workshop? Thank you.
I'm not sure I understood the request. Are you saying if the main session wasn't accepted, could it be moved to?
Move to dynamic coalitions or maybe workshops.
No, I think for yours specifically, Mojina, the notion was that it would probably be most suited for an open forum as a past, Indonesia as a past host of the IGF. So I think those that were proposed as main sessions, of which we've only taken two out so far, we can certainly look at for whether or not there's an appropriate place for them. Julian, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Looking into an exercise highlighting the importance of remote participation, I would like to suggest to request to some proposals that are accepted already to review their proposals for remote participation, which in my point of view are very weak. I'm talking about proposals number 72, 73, 121, 126, 132, and 160. I think it's important to highlight that it's important to improve the proposals for remote participation on those.
Okay, that's a very helpful comment and noted, Julian. Thank you. Renata, you have the floor.
Yes, I would
ask please to address some of the clustering exercise and some of the workshops which relate to a similar theme and also have very similar approach. I would support Jivan's comment on Internet of Things merger of 170. I found 123 to be similar. So those are Internet of Things workshops, 170 and 123. Now, also, I would refer to workshop 100, South School of Internet Governance. It ranked 136. This is a workshop which brings together many Latin American countries and now also Global South countries. And I scanned the whole list of workshop proposals, and I did not see any other proposal addressing schools of internet governance. So this is a very important issue, and I would think that it's interesting for the MAG to consider having this workshop, even if as a conditional acceptance to bring other representatives from other internet governance workshops for a dialogue, other internet governance schools for a dialogue.
Thank you, Renata. I think there's nobody else in the queue to draw a line under this part of the day here. Sorry, Renata, you want to come back?
Also 101 on child online protection from a developing country. I would support.
So I think, as I said a few moments ago, I think we've done an awful lot of work here the last few days. I think we've got a good proposal. I think we're managing across a number of fields, thematic and diversity and et cetera, that we haven't done in the past. I think that will only ensure a more balanced set of workshop proposals. The preparatory process leading up here was, I'm sure, fairly brief for everybody, because even you as MAG members weren't able to see the relative rankings or the total rankings until, you know, a few days before coming, which is not nearly enough time to give it a thoughtful review. It's very, very unfortunate, but it was just the result of the timetable, which we all agreed, and the fact that it was compressed. The good news is, I think, that having gotten through that and having advanced the main sessions fairly significantly, I think we're pretty much back on track with respect to the schedule, with respect to where historically this process has been after the second MAG meeting. I want to thank everybody really for hanging in there for this process. I would like us to get a working group established, and maybe the bucket email list is a good idea as well, but I really think we need to get started now on what we need to do to improve this process for next year. So we can take that to the MAG mailing list. I just don't think waiting until we're through this cycle and the new MAG is appointed, you know, frankly, that will be far too late already to impact anything for the next cycle. Plus, we lose all the learnings, I'll call it that, all the learnings we actually got from this process this year. So we'll take that request to the MAG list, and hopefully we can make some real kind of immediate improvements in the process, both as the calls go out as well as what we actually do to review it within, within the MAG here. But my, truly most sincere thanks to everybody for staying with this process. I'm sure it's not been easy for everyone. Rasha, you have a...
Just very, very briefly, there is a mailing list that was established for a working group on workshop evaluation, so that could serve as the group. If I can resend the email and people can just send their suggestions to that.
Okay, thank you. I do think that could be one of the most important activities we carry forward coming out of this, both in terms of responsibility to the community as we actually set the overall work. So thank you. We have roughly a half hour left with a really hard stop at 6 for many reasons. If folks are okay, we did have one item, which was the follow-up is needed based on status updates from open consultations. If we could take that to the next virtual MAG meeting, I think that would be the most appropriate way to deal with that, and that would leave us time to do a little bit of housekeeping and some organizational efforts, because my feeling is if we don't make a good progress on that in the next couple of days, before we know it, we'll be, frankly, into September with so many of the holidays between now and then, and that won't serve the rest of our planning year well. So I think there was a request to have a discussion on the scheduling of the third face-to-face meeting. I saw a lot of emails come in sort of before and after the lunch hour. I haven't looked at them in the last few hours, so I don't know what the current status is. I'm hoping that maybe Chengatai can give us an update on sort of just where we are overall with that, and if the doodle poll is out already, encourage people to fill it out as quickly as possible. It's hard to call a consensus if you only have 20 people out of 55 or so responding, so we really need to hear from everybody. But is there anything you want to add to that?
Yes, I sent out a doodle poll just after lunch, and we have 30 people have responded so far, and all the dates, week of 19th September, week of 3rd of October, and week of 10th of October, they're all equal at the moment. So, so that's good. And the, it's not good, but... at least we've got a lot of response. The meeting is going to be held in Geneva, and it's subject, of course, to nailing down the actual room, which as soon as we get this over and done with on Monday, we'll try and get the room booked on Tuesday. We've got 30.
Let me open that up for any comments. I see Marilyn and Peter. So, Marilyn, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. Thank you so much for doing the doodle, and I know there was a lot of back and forth. I appreciate the effort to do the doodle. I had asked to have a couple of other weeks considered. I understand there may be reasons not to, but I think it'd be really helpful for us to know if it's a two-day meeting or a three-day meeting, because some of us may be available if it's a two-day meeting, and not available if it's a three-day meeting or depending on the span of the week. I'm even happy to work on Sunday. I wish we could do this meeting on U.S. Halloween. I could bring the candy and the costumes.
But let's talk about the agenda. What are we going to be discussing in the meeting? Because we sometimes have two meetings and we sometimes have three meetings. The reason for the third meeting is basically for the intersessional work. It's one time when we can focus specifically on the intersessional work. All the workshops have been done, etc. So, and then we can just have the final push from the third meeting until the annual meeting. So do we need an open consultation, or we can actually change the format of the meeting if you feel that that's good? I mean, we don't have to stick with that.
Mm-hmm. I'd like to put a plea in for a three-day meeting with a one-day open consultation, because we will have the retreat behind us. I'm sure there will be some things we will want to follow up on as the MAG. I think it's also an opportunity. Hopefully we will have progressed things like this working group on which we can get a head start on there as well. And the intersessional work always takes more time than we think. And frankly, all too often, they're left a little bit too late in the program. So I just don't see how we can do it in just a two-day meeting. And I think not having an open consultation, having had the retreat, and given the fact that I think there's a significant interest in taking whatever suggestions or ideas come out of the retreat and bringing them into the community and possibly bringing some of that to the IGF, would need some preparatory time as well. So I guess my proposal would be for a three-day meeting. Marilyn has a quick follow-up, and then Peter and Renata. Marilyn?
Thank you, Chair. Marilyn speaking. I understand that my interest in working on Saturdays and Sundays is not always enthusiastically shared, but I do take note that, in fact, this time, those of you who are going to the retreat are working on Saturday. So it's I support the idea of an open consultation, which is primarily focused on the retreat and on any other immediately relevant topics. I don't think a full day is needed for the retreat, because I don't think it's appropriate for us to do an open consultation and not also do a online consultation. So I support the idea of an open consultation, but perhaps we could agree it would be a full half day, 3 hours. The second thing is that when we did the work in another group that was very related, the work on the high-level evaluation of the action lines, we started work at 9, and we took only an hour and 15-minute lunch period, and we worked until 6:30, so we had elongated work days. That is, I know in Geneva that's not customary because people in the mission prefer to start at 10, but I think most of us start our working days earlier, so perhaps we could also think about elongating our work days to get a little more work time in. And then secondly, I really have to say, I'm not sure what we're going to do for 2 days after the open consultation as the MAG. I could see a full day or maybe a day and a half. But the workshops are done, the main sessions are done and agreed to.
I don't think the main sessions are done. If the workshop is in September and we're, for all practical purposes, at the end of July with a significant portion of the MAG in and out and in August, I think it would be fantastic if there'd been a robust discussions. The charters have been updated. They'd had discussion with the MAG and support, but I actually think that's a pretty heavy lift in the next 5 or 6 weeks. Let me go to the rest of the queue for a moment. We have Peter, Renata, and Liesl, and then come back to your point, Marilyn, about whether or not we need the full 2 days. Peter, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I wanted to add an item to the any other business part of the agenda, just to make sure that gets in there. I want to just start a discussion about evaluation after workshops and things which we need to come back to. We've talked a lot about assessing them in advance. I want to talk about evaluating them after they've been held. Just to pick up the point about the workshop, I agree largely with Marilyn and want to push back very hard, and I think that the necessity of the meeting needs to be well established, and I'm not sure that it is. I think starting talking about days before we start talking about agenda shows that we haven't quite approached this in a strictly logical way. I think there is some merit in that there may be something that comes out of the retreat. But other than that, I'm not sure that the case is made for a three-day meeting together. The intersessional work doesn't involve all the MAG as a whole. There's a lot of individual projects with people doing things. I can't see why they can't continue doing that online. And if it's a question of the MAG as a whole approving work done by those subgroups, that doesn't seem to me to require a face-to-face meeting. And without taking everything on, I think if you look through those things, I think we ought to start with the presumption that we should do it by a telephone meeting or even several telephone meetings, and I'm sure we're going to have telephone meetings between now and this proposed face-to-face meeting. So I just think we need to go through a slightly more robust justification process before setting up. As I say, I am conscious that if there's going to be something emerging from the retreat that the MAG needs to look at, and as it stands, we don't know that, so a good precautionary principle would be to start scheduling this. But I'm not sure that the rest of the material justifies it. Thanks.
Thank you, Peter. Renata, you have the floor.
Hi. I would like to remind us all of one important space that will probably be a hot topic by the third meeting, which is the unconference space. I think there will still be some details to be finalized on those spaces. And so I would support the 3 days meeting, and I would support the open consultations. This is a new aspect for the IGF, the idea of having informal spaces, informal activities. And I would support further discussion on the main session and the workshop discussions as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Renata. Liesl, you have the floor.
Thank you. I know that the fall gets very busy for everybody, and scheduling things are really difficult. But one thing we've been grappling with this year is the start, you know, sort of the delayed start for the MAG work for next year. So I would suggest that if we meet, and I think that besides the intersessional work, I get the sense that we might have some finalization on some updates on workshops that needed to be fixed, or that the main sessions needed to be massaged and curated a little bit more. So there might be an ability to add those things to the agenda that I think would also be useful. The other thing I would say is it seems to me that we've all got very fresh minds about ways to improve the evaluation process. As Rasha already pointed out, she can start that discussion right away. I also, as I mentioned earlier on, think that there's improvements that need to be made pretty darn quickly on the proposal form itself in order to line up more closely with the evaluation process, because that's where a lot of the jaggedness occurred for me. So I think that we would get a great jump on next year if we had a part of the agenda for that if we met in the fall. Thanks.
Thank you, Liesl. Elizabeth, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I just wanted to raise the question about, actually I'm going to channel my best Virat because I know he's sleeping and he won't be here to do this, but he was mentioning in an exchange earlier that in one of the earlier years there were main sessions decided in February, and I know that IGF that particular year was in September, but there was a sufficient lead time for people to get speakers, and I appreciate where we are now isn't ideal in terms of timing, but I would be really reticent to see us wait for another MAG meeting, especially late September, October, to finalize the main session aspects, because speakers do have, I mean, especially the caliber of speakers we're talking about for these sessions, do have to decide travel and availability and all of those things. And I think even last year, people were having difficulty with the compressed time frame, so I'd like to just flag that concern. And then I realized last year we had this extra meeting and we had to finish up the MAG sessions at the time, and we had the intersessional work that was the new experiment of the Connecting the Next Billion exercise. And so there was quite a lot of work for us to do together on that in terms of envisioning how this document could work out and discussing that. But I don't necessarily see us having that same level of work and that could be productively done in a large room like this with a face-to-face meeting. So I'm a little bit concerned about the assumption of the need for that, and I'd love to hear more about specifically what we would envision addressing. So I'm not closed to the meeting, and I like the idea of making sure that we have a clear and focused agenda before we finalize any decisions about the length of the meeting or whether it's necessary to do that way.
Thank you, Elizabeth. There were some very thoughtful comments as well. I have two more participants in the line, and then we'll see if we can decide the next steps on this. I have Miguel, and then I have an online participant. So Miguel, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. Regarding what Renata just said, it would be great to have a 2-hour slot in the next face-to-face meeting in order to talk about on conferences and formats, and also to decide which will be the selected lightning session in order to happen. So I don't know if we can do it online or not, but if not, it would be great to have a space here. And also a little question, sorry, I forgot previously. when are we defining the order in which the main sessions are going to take place? Because that's an important subject, I think.
I'm looking for wisdom from Chengetai.
They order online. They can do things online.
Yeah, no, I think we need to get to the point where we're confident enough that we understand what the main sessions are. I think we're quite close, although they need some work. And maybe we can look at a draft agenda and try and get that out within sort of 2 weeks once we go through the next spin of the workshops. Does that work?
From now?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Two weeks from now would put us at the end of July. We could go a bit later than that, but I'm not actually sure what we need to know before we determine where the large main sessions are held.
Is fine, but not a completed agenda.
No. It was
we need to talk with the workshops.
Sorry, it was just the main sessions.
Okay, yeah, no, that's
mm-hmm. So it seems as though 2 weeks we should have, maybe even a little bit sooner, just get a proposal out for, we know when the main session slots are, a proposal for how they would be filled and try and advance that pretty significantly over the next couple of weeks. We have an online participant, Anya.
Yes, Ginger reminds us that we should also return to the need for a newcomer's booth, newcomer's badges, and mentor's coordination. Thank you.
No, they're very good points, Ginger. Thank you. I have Flavio in the queue as well. So, Flavio, you had the floor.
Yeah, just a short reminder regarding the next face-to-face meeting. Last year, we had reports from the main session co-facilitators. So we have to have now formally defined who are the facilitators, the MAG members that are facilitators of each of the accepted main sessions. There are steps that have been defined by the working group led by Liesl and Virat regarding the follow-up now, what has to be done for the organization, successful organization for the main sessions. And we have to report on this during the next face-to-face meeting.
I think those are all very important points. I don't know, my sort of temperature of the room here, I guess, and online participants, is pretty neutral as to whether or not we need a meeting or not. Perhaps we could, there's been a number of suggestions for things we need to do. Some of them we could clearly do in virtual meetings. Some would be much easier to do in a face-to-face virtual meeting. The timing comes into account here as well. So I don't know if it makes most sense for me to go away with the secretariat to ask all of you if there are some large topics that you think we need to address over the next few months to please send a note to the MAG list. And we can look at some high-level scheduling, both through some virtual meetings and possibly having a physical meeting, depending on the items that have come in. Feels a little bit like we're doing this a little bit too much on the fly, and I don't feel like I have a good sense as to whether or not there's enough to make for a substantive meeting or not. I know I lean towards saying I think there's a lot of useful work we could do to improve things like our this entire evaluation process and the proposals and things we could do to get a start. I'm expecting that there's some things coming out of the retreat, since most of the items there are, you know, pretty much about improvements, a la the CSTD, and there's certainly a lot of people that feel that that work hasn't advanced quickly enough. There is no way to advance that in any substantive way, I think, if we're not actually physically meeting and doing some hard work. I think the virtual meetings are not all that successive for really deeper work. But I don't see a lot of support for people saying they're convinced that there's enough to do here to go away and schedule a physical meeting at this point. If that's wrong, please, somebody. Suppose I could go for a sense of the room since I see a mixture of bodies. I mean, when we think about all the work that's ahead of us, do we believe that it would be useful to have a physical meeting of, I don't know if it's 2.5, 3-day duration? or we try and get by with a series of virtual meetings over the next 2 months. I think that's sort of what's in front of us. So Marilyn, Aubrey's actually in the queue first, and then Marilyn, and let me see if we can get a sense after. Aubrey?
Thank you. I tend to think that at this point it's far too soon. For example, to assume what can come out of the retreat. Anything can come out of the retreat to, we want you to do more work to, you know, the MAG can be replaced by some other mechanism and will be done by somebody else. It's a complete black box at the moment to make any assumption that it will come out with work for us is that. I have experienced quite frequently in the whole IANA transition periods where we have done intense work periods of 3-hour online meetings rotating through the day where people have gotten work done. We need to get better at learning how to do remote participation work and perhaps a couple meetings where we actually use the tools and all participate remotely. We'll find that we can get more done without spending 2 to 3 days traveling to a place, all getting tired, and just learn to work online. I think it can be done, and I don't think we need to meet at this point.
Okay, thank you, Aubrey. Marilyn, you have the floor. Herman, and then we'll move.
Thank you, Chair. Let me endorse what Aubrey just said, but I think we need to understand that's going to require us to improve our working methods and our willingness to actually really work for more than an hour and a half, and to also make sure that when we have a problem, I'm just going to mention a number of the MAG members, some from developing countries, me, sometimes we get disabled from the MAG list and we don't actually get the notices. So we can follow up on that, but make sure that that means we're reaching everybody. That's one thing. The second thing is, Chair, I would prefer that you make a proposal for a 2-day meeting versus a 3-day meeting, because it may be possible to dedicate 2 days but not three. Then the final thing I'm going to say, because I think it deserves saying, look, I'm a small business from North America. Going to Geneva, cheapest cost, which I pay for myself, I have no funding, is a minimum of $2,200 to $25. I'm not complaining. I signed up for this. But when we consider holding a multiple-day meeting, it is a huge burden on those of us who self-fund. I really support that travelers from the developing countries are eligible for funding, but if I have to spend 3 hours online in a working session with all of you, as the CCWGs have done, and that allows me to save $2,500, that might mean I can come to Mexico.
Thank you, Mexico. Oh, my goodness. I'm so sorry. Thank you, Marilyn. Herman, you have the floor.
It's long 3 days. Thank you, Madam Chair. My comment was going to be very, very related to what Marilyn said. I think more of the issue of the agenda, I think, is a matter of resources. Many of us are working for companies, organizations with tight budgets, and it's important to provision those resources in advance in our previous year budget. In my particular case, I was not expected to have a third meeting this year because it was not clear. I think it's as part of to improve our method of work, we should try to establish the number of meetings that the MAC is going to have in a particular year. That would be my suggestion. And in addition to that, as part of the discussion, I do feel that we might indeed to have this meeting. We have a strong commitment for the success of the IGF, and I think as part of my personal feeling, we have content enough for a third meeting of the year. Thank you.
Thank you, Herman. I think actually in the first MAG meeting, there was an assumption that was noted that there would be three meetings this year, but all your points are very relevant. I think what I'd like to do at this point is ask the MAG members to submit any large topics or subjects that they think we need to address. I'm not even asking for specificity, whether it's virtual or face-to-face. Then we can sit down with the secretariat, look back at past year's agendas for third meetings, and work to schedule that out and present a more thoughtful proposal to all the MAG members in the coming weeks. I guess that means the doodle poll is sort of shelved for the moment. I think, actually, let me take that back, since I think Liesl wants to come in the queue for a moment. Liesl, you have the floor.
Me to breach protocol here. I think actually, in case there is a physical meeting, you might want to do the doodle poll anyway, so you don't have to start that whole thing again. I mean, just so you have that, even if we decide not to do it, or we decide to do it remotely on those days, people have, I mean, I don't know, I just recommend trying to find a date anyway.
That, I think there are other heads around the room nodding yes, so I think that's probably a good thing. So we'll let that stand, and Chengatai and I, the secretary and I, can work on possible draft agendas. We're coming to the very end here. Before we actually do the kind of final closing remarks, I'd actually like to obviously thank Yolanda and Victor earlier for their support of the meeting, and obviously all of their sort of hosting interests and things, and give the floor to Yolanda for some closing remarks. So if you could please light Mexico's mic.
Well, thank you all. It has been a very interesting experience. In representation of Ms. Alejandra Lagunes and Victor, we are very pleased to have the opportunity to be hosting IGF. It has been challenging, and we are very grateful for all your feedback and all the comments that we have received during the last 3 days regarding how we can make this happen in full alignment with IGF principles. So that would be my major message. We are very, very grateful. And I think the conclusion of all this process has been very aligned to the subject of our meeting, the fact that we have a main session on SDGs, and I was reviewing all the workshops that were in the final list, and all of them are aligned to all of the 17 SDGs. So I think that was very important. I was reviewing that while I was listening to all of you and all the proposals. So I think this being the first IGF after the mandate and after the 2030 Sustainable Development Goals approval for the General Assembly last year, that also provides very interesting content on what is coming next. So we really thank you for all your comments. We would like to express our gratitude for all the support to the challenge that we have in front of us, and we look forward to see you in December. Thank you.
Thank you, Yolanda. I'd like to give my thanks again to all the MAG members here, and a specific shout out to all those that are participating online. This has probably been one of the more painful online participatory processes the MAG has experienced, and really appreciate so many of them for hanging in so long. This has been an awful lot of work. These processes are never as smooth as we'd like them, but I just really want to thank everybody for hanging in there. I think everybody worked really well. I think people were very respectful of different opinions and really tried to lean into the process, even if it wasn't the most elegant process we've ever followed here. So much appreciated. We couldn't have made that progress without everybody's will to really get through to the end. So we have a number of thanks. We have to thank the interpreters for all of their activities. To thank the transcribers, because I can't tell you how much I had to rely on those notes. And in fact, they've been very useful going back to past years in terms of understanding processes as well. Really like to thank the UN staff here in the room who have really helped significantly with the electronics here. Obviously, all the IGF secretariat in particular, they've worked incredible hours and eat what? Chengatai was looking for Eleonora, who, I guess she must have stepped out of the room. We can give her our thanks afterwards. Peter and Herman are in the queue here, so we'll give you a quick moment. Peter?
Thank you, Chair. I wonder if I could just perhaps get a sense of the room, because if there's general agreement with what I'm going to say, then we can go ahead and do it. And that is that we need to start on some kind of post-event evaluation. This is done normally two ways, by leaving a piece of paper in the room with some tick boxes. You'd need to make it really, really easy because people get up and rush off. You can also put up on the screen a link where people can go and answer the same questions, tick, tick, tick. And I think we need to get that as extra data for making the assessments for coming years. Yes, we've got previous proposals, and yes, we've got their reports, but audience reaction is really going to be another very useful piece of information as we go forward. So if I could just get the sense of the room, Chair, if you could take that sense, I'll put together a small drafting group or start online the drafting of that little, effectively a questionnaire. And our reason why I think we need to start now is when people are being told that their workshop or their event has been approved, they need to also be told that it is going to be evaluated in this way. I think that should be part of the information they start with, knowing that it is going to be evaluated by that process.
No, I think that's a very good suggestion. So let me look around the room here. And again, online participants, if you have a position, comment. Is there support for trying to find a way to get an immediate post-workshop evaluation? See lots of heads nodding yes, nobody speaking against that. Rasha, you have a comment?
If I may just add that it needs to be an evaluation for the workshops as well as probably for the organizations so that we can learn from what they tell us.
I initially thought Peter was going to suggest an evaluation for this MAG meeting, which is, I think, a reasonable idea as well. Okay, so I think there's agreement to go forward and do that. So, Peter, if you could advance that in the list so we can actually get the specifics out. Herman, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I would like to start with the final apologies because I'm going to take the dare to speak on behalf of the whole group. But I think it's good to raise also a note of appreciation and congratulations for your work for the last 3 days. The doodle poll is a key reflection of this group. Its preferences are almost equally distributed among the three options. And maybe sometimes it's like a herding cat, but you have done a very fine job the last 3 days, and thank you very much, Linda. Thank you.
I think with that, we're done. And as somebody said, I can return to you the gift of 2 minutes of your life. Thank you all very much, and travel safe.